Hello, welcome to the self-learning podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start discussion on Unit 6, Political Economy of Development. And our topic is Agenda of the Political Economy of Development. Thus, there is a clear recognition of the ability of growth cum poverty reduction policies to realize the potential opened up by the scientific and technological revolution. Resource availability, physical, financial, technical, human, organizational, and the basic humanistic value structure ostensibly supported by almost all the major schools of thought and ideologies. The basic question facing development theories now is that despite over two centuries of modern economic growth based on industrial revolution of various vintages and over half a century of a highly mobilized national and international endeavors, fairly limited positive as also perverse anti-development outcomes have been obtained. Moreover, the limited positive gains remain confined to a selected few. Even this has been obtained at an incalculable economic and non-economic cost, even to the beneficiaries in terms of moral, social, political, psych, aesthetic, communitarian aspect of life. Moreover, massive multifaceted deprivation, degradation, and dehumanization has become the fate of the vast majorities who were made to carry the cross of modernity and industrialization. Thus, on balance, it may not be an aggression to treat the global growth and industrialization of the last five centuries as the case of the mal or perverse development. Development as a normative, holistic social process and outcome is by definition and in its essential logic inconclusionary, humanizing, empowering, continuous, and based on justice and freedom, has to be the concern of the political economy of development or development studies. Given the above mentioned identification of the problem of development, it is clear the PED has to have an approach different from that of conventional or mainstream development theories. Surely many elements and insights of the mainstream theory would be of great help to PED, but by means of their creative selective adaptation and reinterpretation. Many correctives, reinterpretations, and alternatives have been proposed in response to the theoretical inadequacy and optional failures of the development policies derived from the growth paradigm. Employment, basic needs, redistribution with growth capabilities, approach, etc., emerged as alternations or corrections to the GDP approach. However, none of these approaches seem to have identified the basic problematic of the development debate. Generally, the development theories have been addressed to those who can or ought to intervene for organizing or accelerating development. It means national and subnational governments, market entities, national and international formally organized groups, generally called non-government organizations, NGOs, but better treated as civil society institutions were expected to respond to and make use of development theories or make the road while traveling. By and large, the state and market institutions have been the major foci of theory. controversies and political advice concerning development. Though the state centricity has many limitations like negation or downplaying, even restricting individual initiative, fostering dependence, fostering excessive centralization and paternalism, neglecting bureaucratization, taking the nation state as the unit of analysis, ignoring state character and politics, etc. The poor and the deprived tend to see in the state a savior, an entity in which the people in general can hope to have a voice and a hand. At least eventually, and maybe at the certain remove disenchantment with both the state and market led to directing attention to civil society institutions. Among these, often it is the NGO who mistakenly were treated as the synonymous with civil society. The PED requires that in addition to the state and the market, it should be addressed the entire range of civil society institutions and should not remain focused exclusively on the state or the markets or NGOs. It is fallacy to identify PED with the collectivism or neglect of individual. But yes, the PED does discard methodological individualism, which treats the real and legal persons as autonomous operating entities. The interest group coverage of the PED, which studies society with their multiple disaggregations, is quite diverse and comprehensive. Since the processes of development are holistic, the subject matter of PED has to be comprehensively concerned in a historical perspective with the entire complex of the main institutions, structures, attitudinal and value premises of the social individuals along with their interactive processes, so as to point out their potentials and pitfalls. Of course, a holistic integrated approach has to be of necessity to work in terms of abstraction from the secondary and relatively less important in a given context, and has to operate in terms of key variables. It has to draw on the historical experiences of the alternative patterns, processes and trajectories of development in order to help explain and present situation and stage of development, isolate the key variables, their mode of interaction along with facilitating and retarding factors. Evidently, none of this would acquire the necessary edge and purposefulness unless one is able to identify in an integral manner and measure players in the development processes and their values and interests. These processes are historical, organic, integrating various facets like economic, political, social, cultural, and ecological, and of course are subject to influences from outside the national boundaries. Their normative ethical aspect cannot be ignored. The range of institutions from micro level to macro and global level, historically inherited ones and newly emerged or created ones, with all their diversity and commonality, contribute in no small measure to the tough challenge facing the theorists, analysts, and practitioners of development. drawing on the number of sources and historical experience of many countries over the last few centuries, we try to present an overall view of some theories of the political economy of development. Now let us wind up the session and take rest. Thank you very much for engaging yourself with the self-learning podcast.